This is KNEB.TV weather from the KNEB Storm Center, your trusted source for weather.
We're going to be dealing with some snow here through the evening hours as snow wind continues through the overnight hours. And we're going to be dealing with snow showers around. Winds are going to be up in that 15 to 20 to 25 mile an hour range, which is going to produce some blowing and drifting snow. We have winter weather advisories in effect. Snow overnight ending tomorrow, blowing and drifting snow going to be a concern as well. Yesterday we hit 44 degrees after a morning low of 25. We'd end up with 0.04 of an inch of moisture, which is almost more than we've had the whole rest of the month at just 1900, still well below normal for the year. We do have winter weather advisories that are out for almost the entire region here under winter weather advisories. The only exception here, winter storm warnings west of Laramie, between Laramie and Cheyenne. Now, as we zoom out, I could say for most of the time that the whole state of Nebraska, all 93 counties, were under a winter weather advisory. Well, that was the case until these two counties here south of Omaha got upgraded to a winter storm warning. Otherwise, the remaining 93 counties, the 91 counties, I guess, remaining there under winter weather advisories encompassing the entire Cornhusker state. This storm system is going to be fairly big, not big in terms of huge amounts of snow, but big in terms of real estate covered, and everybody's going to get a good dose of 2 to 5, maybe 3 to 6 inches of snow. Temps are in the 20s and 30s across the area right now. Winds have started to pick up a bit. We have 10 to 20 mile an hour winds, which drop wind chills down into the teens. It is going to be colder with this system, and that's what you're going to see. The snow has started to arrive here. It's going to push across the rest of the area through the overnight hours. We'll have breaks. It won't snow continuously. Breaks off and on, becoming more scattered in the morning tomorrow. Lows tonight going to be down into the teens for pretty much everybody in 20s. The snow will help keep a lid on temperatures. Wind chills, though, going to be in the single digits and teens. For tomorrow, we have some clouds to start the day. A few hit or miss snow showers early in the morning. Those will clear out by afternoon. We could see some breaks in the clouds and actually see some sun by tomorrow afternoon, but it's going to be windy again tomorrow, causing blowing and drifting snow across the region. Highs only going to go back into the 30s tomorrow across the region. A few areas here, Cheyenne and Lusk, struggling to get out of the 20s for tomorrow. The good news is we've got some precip coming, a few hundredths for everybody, it looks like. Some areas into 0.4 of an inch possible. I think this part of the area going to be the most favored for the heavier snowfall. And that's what we see showing up here on our snowfall maps. You can see higher amounts here in the area from Sydney over to Oshkosh, slightly lesser amounts here right in the immediate North Platte River Valley, but still should see an inch or two for everybody at least, most likely somewhere in that 2 to 5 inch range, maybe slightly more here from Sydney up through the central portions of the Sand Hills. That is what we expect here for our forecast. Tonight, snow, windy, areas of blowing snow around, 20 to 30 mile an hour winds, lows down into the 20s. For tomorrow, morning snow showers, otherwise windy with blowing snow, winds 20 to 30, gusts 40, 45, not out of the question. We're going to be dealing with highs only in the low 30s. We'll continue cold on Wednesday after morning lows down into the single digits Tuesday night. Wednesday will be in the 30s to near 40 for Thursday. We'll start the new year on Friday around 40, and then a very nice weekend coming our way. Saturday, Sunday, highs back into the 40s and even maybe near 50 degrees. So the first few days there of 2021 looking up compared to what the last few days here are going to be of 2020.